Hello, I'm Jessica from Cocoon, and I want to talk to you today about my favorite product, Rosey Cheeks. So Rosey Cheeks comes in a glass bottle, and it's 100 ml, which is very generous for a facial cream. And here it is. And it's a beautiful cream. It's not very thick, and it absorbs really nicely. So you can use it in the morning as a day cream, and you can use it as a night. That's what I do. The reason I created this cream was I was a total cream fan, I guess you could call it. I tried everything, and I was obsessed with finding a cream that would actually feel like when you put it on, you could actually feel something. All these creams that I was spending tons of money on, I would put them on and it was always disappointing. I always felt like it wasn't doing anything. It just didn't feel different. So when I created Rosey Cheeks, I was determined to create that cream that I had always been looking for. So I basically started with the lipids. I wanted to find the oils that had the most antioxidant active properties in them. So I chose rosehip, avocado, and green tea seed oil, which is also called camellia oil. So I'm going to kind of go through those oils to let you know where my thought process, how that happened. So with avocado oil, it's really high in oleic fatty acid. Oleic is really important. Not only is it in our skin naturally, but it's also a very good deliverer. It tends to take nutrients deep into the skin, which is what you want, because you want to be able to impact the collagen and elastin in your skin. It also has linoleic acid, which is also known as omega-6. And that fatty acid is very anti-inflammatory. And it's a very light oil. It's not heavy. Fatty acid. And then it also has vitamin A, D, and E, so we get these amazing antioxidants. It has lecithin, and it also has phytosterols, which help with supporting the collagen elastin production in your skin. And it also has carotenes. When we get our organic avocado oil, it comes really deep green, which is very different than conventional grown avocado oil or processed avocado oil, which comes in as golden. So that green pigmentation tells me that there is carotenes in this. And the carotenes are photoprotective. In plants, they protect the plants from sun damage, and on our skin, they also protect our skin from sun damage. Doesn't mean it's a sunscreen, just means it's protecting the cells from the damage that may happen from UV rays. So then we also have rosehip oil. Rosehip oil is by far the best anti-aging ingredient in the world. I'm convinced of it. It's just very, very active. I wouldn't go a day without putting it on. So what it has is it has an equal percentage linoleic acid, omega-6, and linoleic acid, omega-3. So it's equal parts, so that you get both of those polyunsaturated fatty acids that are extremely anti-inflammatory and but very light and very nourishing. And then it also has vitamin A, like a lot of vitamin A. And the vitamin A, also known as transretinoic acid in this case, is very good for building the dermis, so keeping everything nice and firm. And that's really important. You don't want, you know, things to kind of like fall, you know, get loose as time goes by. You want things to stay nice and firm, so it supports the dermis. And then we have the lycopene, which is another carotene, protects sun protection. So, you know, it's just very active, very, very amazing antioxidants that support your skin and make it look amazing. I know a lot of people are fans of rosehip oil, as am I, and there's a big reason for that. Okay, and then we have the tea seed oil. So that's like tea, like you drink tea. It's the actual seeds that are pressed. So some of the same elements as you would get in tea. You get the polyphenols, But then you also get a lot of oleic acid, which is that great deliverer that I was talking about. And there's also squalene. And then there's shea butter. And shea butter is amazing. It has 17% unsaponifiables, which means active ingredient. 17% is a lot for any type of plant ingredient. So in that amount of 17%, there's the vitamin E, there's vitamin A, and there's cinnamic acid. So in Africa, it is traditionally used as a sunscreen. So that explains a lot about why the cinnamic acid is definitely has that property. And there's also the saturated fatty acids in there, which are the oils that don't melt in room temperature. They're solid, they're firm. So they are very good for protecting from water loss and from the elements. And they put a nice protective layer on your skin. So yeah, shea butter is amazing. So it's all these oils in the shea butter might seem like, ooh, that seems really rich, but it's an emulsion, so it's in water, so you're not getting a huge amount of these oils. You're getting just enough to moisturize without clogging your pores or feeling thick or feeling greasy. Now, very oily skin types might think, okay, this is a little much, so I definitely would recommend it to normal to dry skin types rather than the really oily skin types, but people that have, some people that are acne prone have dry skin and they find they get a lot of success with rosy cheeks. So it's kind of something you have to try and figure out for yourself. And the one of the best conditions it treats is rosacea. We have so many people with rosacea using rosy cheeks. That's because there's so many polyunsaturated fatty acids that are anti-inflammatory and very cooling. The fact that it's a water-based cream is very cooling as well. And there's also rose absolute, which has a bit of anti-inflammatories and is quite antimicrobial. So and it smells very nice too. So it has that rose scent in it. It's a real rose. It's not a fragranced rose. A lot of people are very used to a rose fragrance, but this is like the real thing. And it's extracted from actual rose petals. And it's a yeah, it's a beautiful cream. I've been using it now for since 2006, so that's 12 years. And you know, I feel like, I mean, it's the only thing I use morning and night, and I feel like it's really made my skin look great. I'm 44 now, and you know, I haven't had to go the Botox route or do any injections. I feel like I have, my skin still looks really good and firm and healthy, and I totally attribute it to rosy cheeks. So if you have any questions, always feel free to email, and we'll answer them as soon as possible. Thank you.